Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I want to contribute to this motion again. And as you know, persons with disability are children who are born, and they are our relatives, they are our sons, they are our daughters, and it is very important that we care for them as a nation. And we know the situation and the status that they are living in. The truth of the matter is the schools that we have currently that we call special education schools have no adequate resources. They have no enough teachers who are trained to the areas of disabilities, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, we know that the schools that are there are public schools, and there are few of them. As I said the other day when I was contributing on this, that I come from Garissa County, and Garissa County has one special school. And that one special school, Mr. Speaker, that Garissa County has is in a very pathetic situation, Mr. Speaker. The condition under which our children with disability are living in, Mr. Speaker, is wanting in this country. Mr. Speaker, if you go to that particular school, there are no beds, there are no beddings. The children do not have wheelchairs. The classrooms are in a very pathetic situation. They have only few teachers who have been trained, I think two teachers, the whole county, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, and I support fully this motion where we are asking that every constituency, at least, let's have a special school. Because that school in Garissa that I'm talking about, all the constituency children are brought there, and some of the children are not even brought to that school, so they miss the opportunity of acquiring education, Mr. Speaker. And if you look clearly in our constitution, Article 53B and Article 54, it gives guarantee, Mr. Speaker, for every child, whether normal or a child with disability, it guarantees free education, Mr. Speaker. It gives free education, free and compulsory education, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, it goes ahead and talks about the provision by the government, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, my time is running out, but I want to say, Mr. Speaker, in conclusion, that we have a responsibility as a nation, and this house being budget-making house, Mr. Speaker, we have a responsibility to look into giving resources to Ministry of Education so that the Ministry of Education can deliberately now go out and do a mapping and give proper education to our children with disability, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, our children with disability are a resource. You have seen a young man using his foot in cultivating, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, we cannot waste almost 20% of our human resource in this country by leaving them and neglecting them. There have been rituals around persons with disability, but it is our responsibility to break that ritual so that we can give space, opportunity to the people, to the children with disability, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, with those few remarks, I want to say that it is important that we support this motion, and that the committee, that the relevant committee again, must be on education, must critically look at the way they do when they are giving resources to the Ministry of Education when during the budget. They should look how much is given to the persons with disability in this country in their special